Hey folks, it's Mrs. Mays for AP Chemistry, and it's time to work through another equilibrium problem. This time we're going to use the solver in a problem where K is very small. So here's our reaction. Oh, very fancy. 2NOCl yields 2NO plus Cl2. Our equilibrium constant is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 5. That really is small. So we're given the number of moles, but they're all mixed in a 1 liter container, so that makes our concentration easy to calculate in the beginning. How do we get the equilibrium concentrations? Well, you know what we do. We put it into a rice table. So we start with our balanced equation. 2NOCl, and then here's my arrows, so I don't need to use this column for numbers. Makes 2NO. And Cl2. I'm going to go ahead and write my equilibrium expression right up top here. What do I want? Let's see. I need to have products over reactants. So NO gets to be squared, and Cl2 is just raised to the first power all over the concentration of NOCl to the second power. Right, okay, there's our equilibrium expression. Our initial concentrations were given to us of all of our substances. We had everything in here. So I have 1.20 moles in 1 liter, so moles per liter, of NOCl, and then I have 0.45 moles of NO and 0.87 moles of Cl2. So the question is, which reaction is going to go, the forward reaction or the reverse reaction? We're going to have to calculate the reaction quotient and figure out what way do we go. Are we losing products or are we losing reactants? So let's put products in. 0.45 gets to be squared because that's the NO. Oh gosh. Then the chlorine is 0.87, not squared. And in my denominator, I have 1.20, and that one is also squared. So the result of all of that, let's see, I got 0.15 on my handy calculator. I hope you're following along on your calculator, just for good practice. We're going to go ahead and use the solver on this one. So if you need to push pause and get your calculator out, do that right now, because you need to follow along. That is how we learn. Now let's compare Q to K. Q is 0.15. K is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 5. So Q is greater than K. What that means is, we're going to be losing our reactants, right? No. We're going to lose our products. I've got to shift to make my number smaller, so I need this part to decrease. My numerator needs to go down. So to get the smallest possible amount of X that I can, what I'll do is put my X for the equilibrium value of NO. Since that one is doubled, then everything else is going to be based off of that one. All right, next. We have to figure out what is the change. So if my equilibrium is equal to initial plus change, and my initial is 0.45, and my equilibrium is x, then the change is going to be subtracting the 0.45 over, right? So it's x minus 0.45. That's my change. But that is for NO. Cl2 is only half of that, because NO has a 2 in front, Cl2 is only 1. Remember, mole to mole ratios are important for our stoichiometry. So if I had half of x minus, what's half of 0.45? 22.5? Does that sound right? It's half of 45, so 0.225. So I cut those numbers both in half. X gets cut in half, and 0.45 got cut in half. and then I add these together to get my equilibrium value. Combining like terms, I get 1 half of x minus, that's going to be positive, because 0.87 minus 0.225 is 0.645. Okay, now we're going to use more stoichiometry, because if I gained some here, I had to lose some there, and I have a 2 to 2 mole ratio. That's lovely, because I don't want to deal with hard math. I like it when the math is easy, but I do have to change the signs, right? Because what I gain on the one side, I had to lose from the other side. And then my equilibrium value is 1.65, combining like terms, minus x, because the x was negative. All right, let's get rid of our Q calculations. I don't need those anymore. I just use those to figure out what my reaction is doing. Now we're going to use the value of my equilibrium expression, 1.65 times 10 to the negative 5, and we're going to, I used the small x assumption. We're going to put our values into the equilibrium expression that I had written before. So NO2 goes up top, and then x over 2 plus 0.645 also up top, and I have to square this. That's where that came from. And then down below, 1.65 minus x also gets squared because I have these coefficients out in front. So in the equilibrium expression, those things get squared. And I decided that when I'm adding half of x to this number, it's not going to make much of a difference at all. So I can ignore it. Small x assumption. And when I subtract x from 1.65, I can ignore that too. That's the small x assumption. So let's make sure that the reader knows that's what we're up to. We made the small x assumption. And now we're going to calculate the value of x. So Kc equals x squared times 0.645. Decimal likes to disappear, divided by 1.65 squared and that's equal to 1.69 times 10 to the minus 5. So we'll have to work out our algebra, and when I did my work, please feel free to check, make sure that I got it right. I got that x was equal to illegible handwriting. So x equals 8.2 times 10 to the negative 3. So we said we wanted to choose where we place the x to make sure that we get it to be the smallest possible. And I got something in the realm of 10 to the negative 3. I did a good job, because that's pretty small. So now let's answer the question they asked. What is the concentration at equilibrium of each of our components? So my concentration of NOCl is 1.65 minus 8.2 times 10 to the negative 3. And that's not going to make any difference because, it might. We got to call that 1.64 molar. Let's just check that with the calculator. Okay, so I had 1.65 minus 8.2, and my scientific notation e to the negative 3. Yeah, that rounds to 1.64. Okay, so a tiny little adjustment there, NOCl, and then NO has an equilibrium value equal to x, so NO is 8.2 times 10 to the negative 3 molar. And then finally, we calculate the concentration of chlorine at equilibrium by taking x over 2 plus 0.645 molar, and that gives me 0.649. I just want to check it. Okay, so I have 8.3 scientific notation e to the negative 3 divided by 2 plus I had 0.645. All right, 6.64915. 3 sig figs allowed. So my chlorine was 0.649 molar. And that's it. Let's check our small x assumption. If I have 0.0082, that's the 8.2 times 10 to the minus 3, over my next smaller value would be 0.649, then that percentage is only 1.2%. So we're okay. We're well within our 5% range. And on this one, using the small x assumption turned out to be pretty simple, so I didn't use my solver. That's all right. We have lots of other times when we do get to use the solver. Great, so I'll see you in class. Keep practicing.